The 21st century began with people across the globe fearful that the Y2K computer bug would wipe out civilization. The nation breathed a sigh of relief when that disaster never materialized, only to be blindsided almost 2 years later on September 11th, 2001, by a threat no one saw coming. But there were signs of hope also. When Harry was first encountering the work of Martin Luther King in the 60s, he never dreamed he'd see an African-American president in his lifetime. And there were other things he never thought he'd live to see.
Like the Red Sox winning the World Series?
How do you know about that? I thought you hadn't got your wings yet.
Billy Sunday told me. He still watches all the games.
Oh. And in this last decade, Brunswick Church has stretched its ministries around the world. Another pastor was added, Chris Garrison, who brought skills in organization and management. A new worship center was completed in 2005, making room for the many new families that had joined the church community. Toward the end of the decade, Chris moved on, Kate retired, and for a while, Harry was back to being a one-man show, just as he was when he first came to Brunswick. But soon, Elizabeth Shen O'Connor came on board, bringing yet another new perspective to the church leadership. And now Harry has decided that it's his time to move on.
Who will take Harry's place?
No one can take Harry's place. But an old friend has come back to the church to take the baton from Harry and lead it into the decades to come.
This train carries saints and sinners. This train carries losers and winners. This train carries whores and gamblers. This train carries lost souls. You don't need no ticket, just get on board. Praise God.